Hello, everyone. Hopefully, you guys are having an amazing day today. So, we're gonna go ahead and get into today's stream. Oh, okay. I gotta make sure I have the BRB screen ready, just in case. You never know when that happens, but there's that. Here we are, doing this. We're starting Act 2 of the Archon Quest. That'll be fun. As you can see, off stream, I just got the teleport waypoint, or the statues of the seven, so I know where all the teleport waypoints are so that I don't get lost. That's the one thing that I don't like to do. And as you can see, there's a world quest here that I have yet to claim because I just didn't want to. And I also didn't want to get close enough to starting something when I have just completely did this. So we're going to be doing this mostly for this stream. So we're going to be doing Act 2. I don't know if there's an Act 3 available. I think it's just Act 1 and 2 that are available as of right now for Fontaine. I could be wrong. And then I think we have Linny's story quest. Yeah. So I'll have to get that when I can. Which it'll be fine. I'll probably do that next stream if there is no Act 3. Probably do Act 2 and 3 if it's available to us.
I came here several times with my father when I was little, but stopped eating here as often after growing up. I hope the food here will be to your taste.
Apologies, gonna get my candy back out. I didn't get enough of it yesterday. Gotta get myself some chocolate since we're here in France. It feels like a necessity.
Oh, don't worry. We haven't eaten at a hotel like this in a while. Paimon's getting excited already.
In that case, I'll go order for us first. Please wait here a moment.
Ooh, everything looks so good. People in Fontaine sure know how to enjoy life.
Why, of course. Go ahead, try whatever you like. If the food's good, I'll make a group reservation for the rest of Spina di Rosula next time.
And if it's not?
Well, then I'll still bring everyone. Albeit with only one dish per table.
Mm.
You, sure have your own way of doing things. Oh, we called this a farewell meal, but we could also treat it like a victory feast, right? We did just win that case, after all.
It was nice working with you.
Oh, true. Very true. In that case, boss, we'll have another two dishes.
I'm not smart enough for this whole Tuesday Demas shit. I didn't mean that
Speaking of cases, do you think that the mastermind behind the serial disappearances will get caught soon now that this has all happened?
Well, we've certainly taken a big step forward, but I feel that's about it. We know that there's an organization that means to dissolve these young women, but we still don't know what they are really after.
If it hadn't happened right in front of us, Paimon wouldn't have ever believed that a person could be dissolved like that.
Right? Yet it was because this was such a preposterous notion that the investigation could never really move forward before.
Ugh. If only that guy could have finished speaking! We were so close to hearing who was behind it.
In such investigations, even the smallest step can seem like a yawning chasm if the trail of clues is cut off. To be honest, I don't have high hopes for any follow-up that the authorities might conduct. It's not that I don't have faith in their ability, it's just that a different perspective is required in some matters. It's easy to guard against and deceive a single, narrow perspective. A shift in thinking is required at such times in order to produce a breakthrough. Which is exactly why the Spina di Rosula exist. Those highfalutin folk are not all-knowing. That's why we exist. To seep into the cracks where filth falls through. Where their watch fails them. That's the kind of problems we solve.
Seems Paimon thought things were simpler than they actually are.
It's all right. Well, this was supposed to be a farewell meal, so I doubt you have further interest in this business, right?
Let's
talk about something else. Like, what are your future plans?
We wanted to ask the Hydro Archon for some information, but we're not doing too hot on that.
That's true. It didn't really seem like the right time or place to do it anyway.
I see. So, your primary objective, which has been foiled so far, was to have a chat with the Hydro Archon. I've heard that there's a long line of people waiting to meet Lady Farina. I suspect you'll be waiting for quite a while, considering that you missed your chance today.
Yeah. We've heard that she's super popular here in Fontaine, and that it'll be tough getting any of her time.
Well, would you consider some more, unique ways? Perhaps even methods of, let's say, questionable legality?
No.
Guess that's Spina di Rosula's boss for you. Chock full of sketchy ideas. Well, what did you have in mind?
Bruh, I don't want to become a criminal for like the seventh time, dude.
Performance troupe at the opera house, only to abandon your act at the play's climax and ask to speak to her after the performance. I'm sure Lady Farina would be eager to see the ending and would agree in order to finish watching the play. Don't you think?
Could you suggest something a little more practical? This plan seems pretty hard to pull off. We'd have to go learn how to act, and acting's really hard.
Alright, here's another. Find a way to conceal yourselves under her bed. Then, wake her up in the dead of night and demand answers. Don't let her go back to sleep until she answers all your questions.
Okay, this was a dead end.
I can personally testify that this one works. When I'm sleepy, I'll do anything as long as I can finally get some sleep.
That might work, but that's not really the problem. The problem is, we don't want to get ourselves arrested.
Valid point. I overlooked that part. I was just thinking about leveraging a person's desire for sleep. All right, no more joking around. Perhaps you could... I don't know. Cut the line when she's on a break. You did defeat her in court, clearing citizens of hers from false accusations. False accusations she had nearly upheld personally. I imagine that she feels quite ashamed about the whole thing.
You mean that if we catch her while she's on a break, she might be too embarrassed to refuse? Oh, that does make some sense.
Would someone with her personality really feel shame?
Why don't we give it a try after this meal? You know, strike while the iron is hot and all.
Huh? Paimon, did you drink my Fanta?
Was this your drink? Sorry about that. Paimon wasn't really paying attention and the cup was right next to Paimon. Would you like to order another?
No, it's fine. We're just about done here.
Alright. Honestly, Paimon wouldn't recommend Fanta anyway. It tastes kind of salty and icky.
Salty?
Is that so? Huh. Well, in that case, we'll have to blacklist the Fanta here then. If we're all finished eating, then I'll go pay.
Yeah, we're stuffed. Thanks for the treat, Navia. Oh, so full. Paimon can barely float anymore.
So where are we gonna stay next? You could fly. You could try floating. You could try walking.
Nah, that would be so normal. You know, like you.
Okay. As for expenses this month, we're left with.
Hey, Navia, what are you doing over there?
Oh, she's a poor noble lady.
Nothing. It was just a meal, you know? Nothing the Spina di Rosula can't cover.
Let's get ready to try to meet the Hydro Archon again. Bye, Navia!
So this is goodbye, huh? Well, if you do encounter any other trouble in Fontaine, you're always welcome to contact the Spina di Rosula. I'll give your requests the highest priority. In any case, I wish you smooth sailing. I'll see you again, partner.
Bye-bye! Damn, that's it. Bye-bye. We just begin.
People around anymore. Looks like that boat we took to Aranias might have been the last one.
Vache.
Looks like we're back here again. Huh? Traveler? Are you hearing voices again?
Yep.
Oof. That's kind of spooky. Are you sure we don't want to come back in the morning?
Vache. Vache.
Vache.
Hey. Hang on. Paimon can kinda hear a voice. It's calling for Vache, right? Hey, traveler? Stop walking! Come on, wake up!
Oh, shit. We're dead. Where are we?
Vache, are you my dear Vache?
No.
No, wait. You seem to be someone else.
I'm afraid not.
Do you know where my love is?
I don't know who this is. Who are you?
I'm... Wait. Who am I? I'm very sorry. I fear I do not know. My memories feel like they have been washed away like a flood. So many fragments dissolved amidst the tide, never to be recovered. How much have I lost? How many things that I once held dear while on land have I since forgotten?
Oh boy. Sorry, I had to grab a blanket. You were once human?
Yes, that is what I was once. But now, I am but the consciousness of one who has lost their form. I do not know how I came to be like this either. I only vaguely remember being covered in light blue water, and then all grew dim. I also remember going to many places. I loved adventure, loved exploring places of peril. No matter where I went, Vache would go with me. I knew how dearly he loved me, and I also loved him equally as much. But now, we can no longer go back. The pain of such parting, I never knew how heavy it could be. No, our reunion no longer has any meaning. There is no, the thought of me gives him no succor. So if you meet Vache, tell him not to look for me. Tell him to move on. That is the only thing I still remember. Perhaps that is so. As I was submerged in the waters, losing consciousness, I saw Vache above the surface. His eyes were filled with such sorrow, such longing. If only I could have comforted him, told him that I did not suffer. Indeed, I had felt a great warmth. Is that what you call it? Dissolving? If anything, I consider it a form of release. It was a state of neither fear nor frenzy, with only an endless peace, like the water still surfaced. I could also liken it to being a thirsty person who drinks water for the first time, and only then sees how they have lived for so long in a world of endless want and anxiety.
Seems that after the body is dissolved, some measure of the consciousness still remains.
I think I hear your companion. It's time for you to go, I think.
Is that Paimon? Oh, right. I wonder how much time has passed in reality.
Farewell, then. I am glad that you were able to sense my presence. Remember, if you see Vache, tell him not to seek me out any longer.
The fuck?
Dear God, it's a whole army of Gardamex.
You know, I'm so glad I actually watched those people who analyzed the trailer, because I know that she's on our side right now. Head him up, Nadia. Or not Navia, not Nadia. Sorry. Force of habit. Also, this is some nice music. Like, oh shit, hit him up. Ooh, that's attractive. Both of you. That's hot. Oh, she's so pretty. God.
I should thank you for lending us your sword there, Clorand. But before I do so,
Could you explain how you managed to show up here?
I followed you. It seemed to me that danger has followed you more closely as of late.
I believe that following someone without their knowledge is actually called stalking, is it not?
Mr. Callus's last wish was for me to ensure your safety, and I will not betray his trust. He would do the same.
Oh,
were he alive today.
She reminds me
do
of Sara.
Speak of my father.
Sorry, demoiselle. I was not strong enough.
Thank you for your aid, Miss Curran, but do keep an eye out for your manner of speech. I believe we all wish to avoid unnecessary emotional harm.
Sorry, I did not consider your feelings.
Whatever. What else do you know? How did you come to the conclusion that I'd be in grave danger?
I doubt I know much more than you, but I believe that the mastermind behind the serial disappearances is very powerful. Your performance tonight will almost certainly attract their attention.
I'm sure they've known about me. To be honest, I'm shocked it's taken them this long to act against me. And what about these Gardamecs? I thought only those associated with a Maison Gardiennage could control them.
None of these Mecha have serial numbers. I was sure to check a moment ago. They are not the ones used by the authorities to enforce the law. I can only conclude that some powerful or wealthy party must have obtained them via illegal means, deploying them as a private force of sorts.
What? Your point being that they're out of Spina di Rosula's league, then?
Yes. Be careful, and do not act rashly.
I will continue investigating, no matter what. We will bring the truth to light. That's my father's true last wish. Regardless, thank you for your help today, Clarand. But if you get any ideas, tell me first. I don't much appreciate being followed.
Lauren, she's actually so pretty.
Anytime soon, so I shall stop following you.
She's a better impression than Kujo Sara, though. I'm not gonna lie. She's a lot hotter. A lot. Oh, shit.
Right. I suppose that's the best news we've got.
She's noble. I love her.
Demoiselle, I believe that Miss Clarand was being sincere with you. If we tried, we could attempt to thaw relations a little.
I know, I just... She's...
What the fuck's... What's going on? Who is that?
Oh, thank goodness! Paimon thought we were done for! Those Gardamecs came out of nowhere while you were unconscious, and Nadia and her gang saved us! Oh, and there was that champion duelist named Clarand who came out to save us too! We got lucky there. Paimon probably couldn't have fought them off otherwise.
So you're a fighter, not a beggar or a chooser. Thanks for the rescue, though.
Oh, come now. Forget all that polite talk. That wasn't really a farewell meal we had back there. Not for me, anyway. In truth, I hope that every meal we have together shall be a victory feast. As such, we're still partners. There's no need to thank me.
It will take 50 years for me to match Demoiselle's magnanimity.
If it were me, I would have joined the Spina.
All right, you two. That's enough.
Actually, Navia, how did you know that we were in danger? You sure did show up in the nick of time.
Well, to be honest, you're the one who tipped us off, Paimon.
Huh? Really? Paimon contributed somehow? Ooh, Paimon's even more amazing than she thought!
He said let's go catch her off guard.
All thanks to you grabbing my drink by mistake.
How did that help?
After we parted ways, I was on the way back to one of our bases when I suddenly thought of what you said. That the Fanta tasted kind of salty and icky.
Wait, do you mean that? I thought it tasted strange as well, but I couldn't be sure.
Fanta only comes in sweet flavors. So how could it have tasted salty? The color of the drink, if I recall, had also been a bit off.
So the Fanta had been spiked with water from the primordial sea?
Yes. So, if you hadn't drunk that cup for me...
Spina di Rosula is preparing the grandest of awards for you as we speak for saving the boss.
Huh! Really?
Fortunately, neither of us are from Fontaine, so we could have been... Bleh, you know?
I sent people to Hotel de Boer to investigate, but whoever did this left no trace at all. That's when I figured out that you might be in danger and hurried here as quickly as I could.
But why would they go after us too? All we did was defend Linny in court and help clear his name. Ugh. Now we're caught up in this mess too, aren't we?
Here's my guess. My guess is they went after us because we drank the Fanta in the first place, because it had like some type of tracker in it or something. Because if you think about it, it's like the dissolving water, right? The dissolving water dissolves only with people that are from Fontaine. Otherwise, they'll have to kill them. So they got to get rid of the evidence that they were there. That, or they could have just been like, oh, well, we got to find this. Because they were assuming that Navia was the one who drank it, right? So they're going to follow that person who drank it. And then they're going to make them dissolve. Disappearance of young women.
Well, you did foil a plan that they were probably pretty proud of. And almost got their name in the process. Speaking of which, did anything strange happen when you drank the primordial seawater?
Well, it can't be a coincidence that the Traveler fainted just now. She said that she heard that voice calling for Vashe again. Oh, and this time Paimon heard it too! But it was real faint. Does this situation have to do with the primordial seawater then?
According to Lynette, the ability to hear voices like that has to do with one's sensitivity to the Hydro element.
Does that mean the primordial seawater raises someone's sensitivity to Hydro when it's used on people who are not from Fontaine?
That doesn't sound like too much of a bad thing, to be honest.
I also gave him some new intel.
New intel? While you were out cold?
Well, let's hear it, shall we?
The voice in the fountain belonged to one of the missing women. A person named Vashie was the witness when she was dissolved.
Oh, that is important. Vashie, that name doesn't ring a bell. I suppose he hasn't stepped forward as a witness in court lately. Since he saw that young woman dissolve, he was at least at the crime scene. But he never gave testimony or any information regarding people dissolving in the primordial seawater. Could he have been threatened?
We should try searching for him because I still have a message to send to him.
Yes, thank you. This is very important information indeed. We will continue to investigate.
And by we, you mean us too, because we are now involved.
Oh, you mean you'll help us investigate?
Well, you did say that our farewell meal didn't really count. That means we're still partners, right? And besides, we're in this now whether we like it or not. You're not gonna let those people who targeted us get off the hook so easily, are you, Traveler?
That will prove to be their biggest mistake.
Demoiselle, do try not to look quite so pleased. You are the face of Spina di Rosula, after all.
You talk too much. Well, in that case, let's head back to one of our bases, shall we? I'll arrange accommodations for you.
Mm-hmm.
We also have some plans to go over, and hopefully we can deepen our bonds as partners. But we'll take that one step at a time, I guess.
Don't worry, you two. With us around, our base is definitely secure.
Actually, Child's Vision, I didn't read that, did I? It appears as if Child's lost control of the elemental power within it before. The vision has lost its glow now that the owner has left it behind. Quite interesting. That's not what I came to check out, though. I came to check out the new materials that I got. Local specialty. also a local specialty. It's a material. Cooking ingredient. Oh. Looks like I still need to go for more things, but it's okay. We're getting closer and closer.
It's right up ahead, but let's make sure we weren't followed first.
I've been keeping watch, Demoiselle. I haven't spotted anyone suspicious thus far.
Huh, very good. But let's not let our guard down for now.
I shall find rooms for our respected—
Thank you, Malus. Now, let's continue, traveler.
What a hideout, dude. Wow.
This is your base? It's not quite what Paimon imagined.
Your accommodations have been arranged. Under the present circumstances, I can confidently say it's the best we have.
Thank you.
Well, our funds have been a little tight lately. After all, we don't allow illegal or unethical profiteering. In fact, our funds often come from citizenry who support us.
Seems like it's tough times for everyone. But if you have the support of the people, that does sound like it's worth it.
To be honest, our financial situation was a lot better back when my father was in charge a few years ago. I'm afraid I'm not quite his equal.
Your father? He was the previous boss of Spina di Rosula, right? How did he...
Demoiselle, if you'll allow me to explain.
No. I'll explain it myself. I suppose I couldn't run from this topic forever. And, as partners, this is something I hope they can understand. My father's name is Callus. Yes, the same one they call Callus the Unfaithful in the streets. 3 years ago, he was accused of murdering his own friend. But he chose a duel to defend his honor instead of standing trial. He died in the duelist ring. But I do not believe my father was a murderer. I'm sure he was set up. At the time, I believed that if he only stood trial and was duly investigated, something amiss would crop up and prove, but strangely, he not only requested the duel himself, but rumor has it that even after being seriously injured, to the point where he could be deemed as having lost the duel, he refused to surrender, determined to die in the arena. 3 years later, I still don't understand why he did that. How could he protect his honor
if he's dead? If anything, he gave up his chance to defend himself.
Do you have any clues?
The closest piece of info I have is that my father had been investigating the serial disappearances case at the time of his death.
Ah, so that's why you're so determined to get to the bottom of that case.
That's right. I've also tried to investigate the murder my father was implicated in, but I haven't found a single new clue in my countless reviews of the investigation records. However, I believe that if the murder case is related to those behind the disappearances, they must know something. I must know what really happened. Was my father coerced? Framed? Even if he really did kill his friend, I must get to the truth. If only he'd been more open with me when he was still alive. He even hid the fact that my mother died due to complications when giving birth to me. And now, here I am investigating his death. You really are a handful, aren't you, Papa?
Seeking the truth for the sake of your family. No, we're quite alike.
Demoiselle, please. If there is anything I can do, anything at all.
I also will never believe that Master Callus murdered anyone. There are none whom I respect more than the two of you, Demoiselle. Master Callus did so much good in life, yet all it took was one murder case for him to be dubbed Callus the Unfaithful. Even our supporters decreased greatly due to that incident, hence our strained finances at present.
Wait! If Callus was such a good man, wouldn't people at least be a little suspicious when he was accused?
No. Perhaps people just revel in that kind of drama. It's not something exclusive to people from Fontaine, really. Everyone's like that. People love watching the evil turn over a new leaf, but they also enjoy watching good people fall into an abyss from one slip-up just as much.
But how could... Never mind. If Callus was really falsely accused, we have to find the truth. He didn't deserve to have that happen to him.
There is one other thing. Master Callus's opponent in the duel was Ms. Clorand.
Oh,
her?
Well, then, isn't that as good as saying that she was the one who killed him?
I wonder the mood was a little strange between you two.
Yeah, that's not the sort of thing that you can just let go and move on from.
Miss Clorand has always placed great emphasis on the honorable nature of the duel. If her opponent doesn't yield, she will not stop either. She knew Master Callus beforehand and greatly respected him, but seeing how he was resolute in the arena, there was only ever one choice she could have made.
It's not that I don't understand her at all, but I just can't deal with this yet.
Don't worry, Navia. Paimon knows how you feel. You don't have to force yourself to do that.
Afterward, Ms. Clorand told us that at the start of the duel, Master Callus requested that she ensure Demoiselle Navia's safety.
That indicates that he intended to die.
Yes, that is our understanding as well.
Oh, Papa. What madness drove you to ask the person who killed you to take care of me? All right, anyway, that's the information I wanted to share with you. Even if it did sound like I was just complaining towards the end.
It's okay. It's all right. I understand how important.
Thanks. You two should go and rest. This was quite a day after all.
Yeah! I'm on feet.
Please, relax and get some sleep. We will ensure you rest soundly.
Paimon slept so well. This place feels almost too safe. Huh? Navia? Where did the other two go?
I sent them back to Poisson. It's Spina de Rosula's place of origin, and where we have our headquarters. There's not much for them to do here at the moment.
Paimon gets the feeling that you're just trying to get them off your back. But never mind that. When did you get back? Were you waiting here the whole time?
No, I just returned after going out for a while. I did some investigating yesterday regarding the name Vache.
Wait, so you didn't sleep at all?
How could I after having such critical new evidence appear?
Guess Paimon wasn't speaking for everyone just now, huh?
Unfortunately, this name seems to have been wiped from existence. It doesn't seem to have a match anywhere. I suspect that those behind this have already taken steps to hinder an investigation from this angle. But that does prove that this Vache person is a key witness in the incident.
Does that mean we're too late, though?
No. There is one ray of hope. One place in Fontaine that they would find almost impossible to threaten, no matter how much they wanted to. And that is the archives kept by Chief Justice Nouvellet. A place where detailed files on all the cases in recent years are kept.
Oh boy.
If the Oceanet you met is one of the young women who went missing recently, we should be able to find some related information there.
So Nouvellet maintains an archive of case files? Whew. Guess that's the hard-working Chief Justice for you. In that case, let's go talk to him, shall we? Aren't you coming along, Navia? Did you get tired?
No, it's nothing. Let's go see the Honorable Chief Justice.
Woohoo! Yes, Queen. We are going to see Nouvelle.
Right, come on.
Let's go, Nouvelle. I'm here, sweet honey. That way.
Halt! Please state your business here. The Chief Justice is presently occupied with official matters.
Huh. This place does look pretty heavily guarded. Guess that proves that Nervalet's files are really secure.
Hey, don't you recognize us?
Huh? Who are you? Just to be clear, I don't care who you are or who you might be related to. Our rules make no exceptions.
See? They've got great discipline, too.
Yep, yep. Paimon can tell.
If you're here just to crack jokes, I can point you towards the exit. Unlike some, we're busy, so please leave if you don't have a reason to be here.
No. What I meant to say is, shouldn't you remember us from a few days ago? We were at the trial of the great magician Linny.
Oh, yes, I remember. I read about it in the Steambird. You must be Linny's attorneys. It's all coming back to me now.
We're here today to report and archive some information on a follow-up case.
Huh. Is that even a thing?
Of course. Don't worry. We're here on official business. You can trust us.
All right, then. I'll let you through. The Chief Justice is just inside.
I thought you said he was presently preoccupied.
Thanks so much.
I was lied to by a little... whatever the you want to call that. I saw something shiny. Hello?
Please come in.
Oh my god. Y'all, I'm not ready. I'm about to get married. Again. For the third time. It's okay, this is the third marriage. New region, new person.
It's all right. Please let me know how I may be of assistance to you.
So you're not mad at us?
We're looking for a man called Vache. He may have been an eyewitness in the serial disappearances case.
If we can find him, we may be able to unearth some key information on the case.
Ah, I see. In that case, please wait here a moment while I browse through the files.
Jesus Christ, how many files do you have? He's so hot.
Who knew that Nervalette would be so easy to talk to?
He's so pretty. And perfect. And oh my god.
Unfortunately.
Oh no.
I'm quite certain that no one by the name of Vache has been involved in any case, criminal or civil, in the past several years. There are no records of him either in the files or in my memory.
Traveler, what if it was really just a dream?
Is that so? All right then. Thank you so much, Monsieur Neuvillette. We'll take our leave now.
Ahem.
What do you mean, ahem?
Miss Navia, I can understand how you feel. Your father, Callus, was a truly exceptional man. We deeply regret his passing.
Hmm. And what are you trying to say, Monsieur Neuvillette?
Did you know he wasn't guilty?
Are you trying to console me? Extend your sympathy? Or just express some tendril of regret?
Oh, shit.
You are not trying to do any of that. I can hear it in your voice. There's no emotion behind your words. You only said those things because you felt like you should.
No. Baby!
It's just like last time. After my father took his place in the duelist ring, I pushed through the guards to talk to you as a last resort. You even told me then that you thought there was something fishy with the case, yet you still allowed the duel to go ahead. In your eyes, the value of a human life is nothing compared to those cold laws you hold so dear. If you truly regret my father's death, then why didn't you call a stop to the duel? Why didn't you give me the power to stop him from throwing his life away? Why did you just let him die, despised and hated by all? Everything was hanging on a thread at that moment. Just the tiniest effort could have changed everything. There are still so many things I never got to tell him. So many questions he still owes me answers to. If you really have no heart, then just look me in the eyes. I, Navia, will show you the true meaning of regret.
Navia! Oh.
I'm sorry, Miss Navia.
You and my father are truly alike. You keep all kinds of things in your heart and never say a word to anyone. It's not so much that you can't feel, but that you would never express anything. Oh well. In any case, everyone already knows full well the apathy of the Chief Justice. My apologies for taking my emotions out on you, Monsieur Chief Justice. Let's go, Traveler and Paimon.
Alright. But I don't want to leave! Why? Oh.
Navia, are you okay?
I'm fine. Huh. Rain. It's raining.
You're right. Wasn't it still sunny when we went into the building? And there shouldn't be any active trials today. How strange.
Does Nouvelet control the rain?
Now that I think of it, on the day my father was convicted of murder, it was also raining.
What is it? Did you think of something?
Does Rain remember all? Your father's case, was he outside when it happened?
Yeah, he was outside. It was uncovered and the rain could fall there. Why? Do you think the rain could have affected the crime scene? That thought has occurred to us before. We've even expanded the search area to try to account for that, but didn't find anything of value.
But there was something you didn't know at the time.
Oh? Wait. You don't mean...
The fact that people can be turned into water.
So you're saying that the true murderer could have been turned into water? and then got washed away with the rain? Yeah, and if that's what had happened, then no one would have believed your dad, even if he explained what he saw to the authorities!
I really think I found a true genius for a partner. You're completely right. How did I not connect the dots earlier? All right, let's go to Poisson. With this new lead in mind, we'll get to the bottom of my father's case for sure.
Yeah, we're gonna make progress for sure this time!
Do you want to go with me now? Or do you want to head over by yourself later?
I'll go with you. Just kidding. I'm gonna join later.
And I'll wait for you at Poisson.
Oh, I thought me and Paimon were gonna talk for like a quick minute. Can I go back in? I wanna see him. I wanna see him. No! In hell. Crying. Never mind. Okay. Whatever shall I do? So, how do... Oh, never mind. This how. Okay. Bruh, and I thought Sumeru's exploration was bad. This is gonna suck. I like Navia.
Need to be so surprised. While it may look like a ship, it's actually Spina di Rosula's headquarters. My father was the one who asked for it to be built like this. Perhaps our taste in exterior design is the only thing we occasionally had in common. A gigantic and glamorous ship embodies discovery, opportunity, ambition, and conquest. It symbolizes Spina di Rosula's bright and limitless future.
And Paimon thought you were bluffing when you said Spina di Rosula had a glorious past! Paimon was confused why a group with such a history would live in the sewers! But now that Paimon has seen this ship for herself, she's been convinced!
Well, Poisson is where Spina di Rosula began, after all. It's our main base, our home.
Going. Huh? Get hit by my wrench. It's your own darn fault. I'm just saying, if you play with fire, you're gonna get burnt.
So true, bestie.
Malus, we're back!
Apologies for the wait, demoiselle, and our most important partners. You said before that you still had some business at the court. What brings you back to Poisson so quickly?
About that. It's because my partner here reminded me of something really important. You see, what if my father's case had something to do with water from the primordial sea? You still remember, right, Malus? On that night, it was raining?
Yes, the case was quite similar to that of Mr. Linney's. Both were what you'd call impossible murders.
Could you tell us a bit more about what happened before?
Yeah, of course. Many years ago, something called synth began to gain popularity in Poisson. At a glance, it was a kind of drink that could excite your mood and produce many pleasant hallucinations.
Wait! Didn't that guard
like
guy
a drug
turned into water also mentioned that the primordial water could be used to produce some kind of potion?
Yes, he did. Considering what we know now, it's almost certain that synth is created using water from the primordial sea. If you drink synth for an extended amount of time, you'll suffer many side effects, such as losing the ability to focus or control your emotions. And if you were to stop drinking it completely, you'll experience flashes of paranoia and anxiety.
So yeah, it's drugs.
Lacking energy to do anything.
Woohoo!
It's an extremely dangerous
extended
substance.
Drug use in Tibet.
As he oversaw Poisson, my father was compelled to put a stop to synth abuse and called for a complete ban of it.
Boss's uncompromising attitude incurred the synth vendor's wrath, but no matter how much they threatened or bribed him, he refused to yield. Not only that, Boss became determined to find the mastermind behind the synth operation and put an end to the problem once and for all.
Yes, but the enemy was very cunning. So he could never get anything out of the dealers, all of whom only sold the stuff and weren't privy to the rest of the operation. Recognizing that, my father decided to contact the dealers in secret and cultivate personal relationships with them. Finally, he was able to convince someone to become his informant. The man's name was Jacques. He felt greatly ashamed about his work after seeing many families destroyed by synth abuse.
A true name.
That night, my father hosted a banquet at his countryside estate. He planned to meet up and exchange information with Jacques over some food. But then, we heard two gunshots from the courtyard. We raced to the scene and found my father, still holding a gun, and Jacques, who was already dead on the ground.
Huh? How did that happen? Aren't they on the same side?
Sounds just like Lenny's case, doesn't it? In both cases, the culprit seemed obvious, but neither appeared to have any motive at all. Looking back on it, though, I now believe the most important clue was something we all overlooked at the time. There were pieces of clothing left at the scene.
So they could have belonged to someone who got to Saul.
Precisely. It's all thanks to you that I made the connection now. Back then, we all just thought they were some costumes that Jacques used to disguise himself at the banquet. But, considering it now, it's almost certain that they belong to a third person at the scene. With one extra person, we'll also need to reconsider why the two shots were fired.
Maybe your father got into an argument with him. It's possible that the third person was to blame.
You're right. We still don't know what happened. But my intuition tells me that we're on the right track to figuring it all out. I'm finally headed towards the truth.
Listen, if we think about this clearly, the most obvious case is that the third person did it, but they're a pawn to the boss, because that's what the person said in the courtroom with Linnea's case before he disappeared. He was like, yeah, I did it, but I was threatened. I can't tell you about this, but I'm going to tell you anyway. Because our boss, he was like literally saying our boss, indicating that he isn't working alone. He's getting people who have like literally zero convictions pretty much, and he's threatening him. They're like, we'll make you disappear if you don't do so-and-so and frame so-and-so, so that way we can get rid of them and get them out of the picture. These people are getting or wanting to be involved in this. Lenny just, I don't know why Lenny was involved. Maybe it's because he's a Fatui, or because he's a Fatus. Apparently that's the plural of it. I don't know why. But if that's the case, then you have a lot of other things that you need to worry about. Like, for one, the fact that the third party was there, but they were dissolved, right? So if there was a third person there, then that third person could have been the murderer. However, there would be no evidence of that because they dissolved. Also, if there were two guns and there were two shots fired, that means someone else was shot. Unless, and hear me out, what if the two gunshots, one was at the dissolved person? That's what Navia's father was trying to do, trying to shoot the person that literally just killed a friend, right? And then the other one was at his friend. So, in other words, it would be Navia's father shooting towards that third person who got dissolved. And we're assuming that the person was not dissolved at the time of the crime, right? So if we're thinking of that, then they were still alive. They were still well and good. So they might have had a gunshot wound. Because they got shot by Navia's father. Who, you know, in all honesty, it could have been in self-defense if you think about it. If by the time he shot that bullet, that other bullet was in his friend, I would consider that self-defense.
Jacques was an empathetic man who was infinitely remorseful for his past actions. It's unlikely that he turned on Boss with zero warning. I think this third person is probably the key to the full truth.
See?
On that note, however, even though this will not please you, demoiselle, as your and your father's butler, I must still offer a word of warning. Our opponent is insidious and cruel. They are extremely difficult to deal with, and Boss has already lost his life trying to bring them to justice. Even though Spina de Rosula has lost most of its former glory, Poisson has welcomed a new time of peace, and we have been allowed to live out our lives. There is no need to follow your father's path. It would be both wise and in line with Boss's wishes to step back and give up on the case.
For sure,
if
definitely.
If that's indeed what he wished for, then he should have told me that himself. Was I not the closest person to him? And yet, I was the one most kept in the dark. What was the point of him dying without sharing any of the secrets he knew? Did he manage to protect anything in the end? Synth is still here. Callus the Unfaithful is still his epithet. And Spina di Rosula is barely getting by. Nothing has changed. Did he think I'd just accept his meaningless death and live out my life just as meaninglessly? I've never accepted that. Ever. Not since that day, and certainly not now. I want to find out the real answer for everyone's sake. For the missing girls, for the victims, and for myself.
And for your father's sake. Yeah.
This is indeed the best moment to act. Your partner appears to be quite reliable, and more importantly, demoiselle, I think you're also ready to take this on.
So you do know something else, Malouse?
Yes, I do. In fact, even before that banquet, Boss already knew of the connection between Synth and the serial disappearances case. But what drove all the tensions to the boiling point was the revelation that you, demoiselle, had been selected as the next target to disappear.
What?
Boss also didn't tell you that he had been diagnosed with a rare illness. The doctors told him that he had
Elizar?
No more than 5 years left to live, and the serial disappearances case caused him great anxiety. 5 years was nowhere near enough time to resolve this long-standing conflict. But once he passed away, all the danger would pass on to you. Knowing all of this, he decided to use one final intimidation tactic before his death. He claimed to have already gotten his hands on some key incriminating evidence for the other side, and even told some members of Spina di Rosula about the details. But as long as you remained safe, he would not share the evidence with the public. If something were to happen to you, then he and all those he told would immediately expose all they knew about Synth and the disappeared victims.
Right! So nobody would be able to get off scot-free!
As we've seen, Boss's tactic has worked. Even though Boss has been gone for a long time, the other side has not tried to take Demoiselle's life.
No, I don't believe it. He never appeared to look sick to me.
No father wants their daughter to see them weak and haggard, especially someone as proud as Boss. To him, dying in a duel and suffering lasting dishonor as the unfaithful were still far preferable than losing face in front of his daughter.
So he chose to die in silence, so that he could protect me.
I'm afraid you're not understanding this correctly, Demoiselle. What Boss wanted to hand to you was not a parasol, but a sword. If Boss's spirit could hear you telling me that you want to find the answer for the sake of everyone involved, I'm sure he'd be extremely proud.
That fool. Couldn't he have just given it to me straight? No. He might have set up everything precisely because he never thought I'd be able to understand him.
Is that Navia, the Navia, Navia, listen, 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 baby.
What if I was able to make it to where I am now?
Listen, shh, shh. He gave you a choice.
Yeah. I suppose that's true. With the way he'd set things up, if I had wanted, I could have just lived out my life without a care in the world. But thankfully, he rarely talked to me about complex matters, and thus understood little of me as a person. In this case, he really didn't need to give me an easy way out. Huh. Malus, what was the key evidence that he shared with you?
It's the location where Synth is produced. Essentially, it's the enemy's headquarters. When he was threatening the enemy, Boss didn't share the specifics of the incriminating evidence he found.
However,
but if you want to use it against the enemy, you'll still have to take several things into consideration.
Why? If we know where the place is, can't we just go storming in?
You mustn't forget that we're fighting against a mysterious and dangerous organization that's been in operation for decades.
Okay. So, I'm confused still.
There's no telling what might be lying in wait at their headquarters. God. We also have no idea what kind of evidence we may be able to find inside, nor what people we may be able to capture. But a single visit to their headquarters would be tantamount to a formal declaration of war. The worst case would be that we leave empty-handed, but also open ourselves up to full retaliation.
Then, in that case, why not work with the Fontaine authorities?
Would they believe you?
You saw one of them dissolve during Mr. Linney's case. We have no idea just how thoroughly they may have been infiltrated.
Huh. That's true. Seems my father really had no choice. But things are different now. It should be a lot easier to prove the other side's guilt now that we've connected Synth with the disappearances case.
You sound like you've put a lot of thought into this, Malus.
I am the butler, after all. I live but to serve the boss and Demoiselle's will. I've always been willing to take on any kind of risk for your sake.
Please don't die on us, Moose.
Considering my relative lack of ability, I've spent my time keeping secrets, performing basic investigations, and waiting for the right time to come.
Thank you for all of that, Malus. Have you discovered anything new in the past few years?
Let me think. One conclusion I came to is that the enemy must be quite familiar with Spina di Rosula, or at least have an informant planted here. when I announced orders to the organization's members on Demoiselle's behalf, I used to deliberately keep a few people in the dark and observe the reactions of the synth vendors. If the vendors didn't change their plans, then the individuals informed of our orders must be innocent. If the vendors packed up and fled, however, then someone must have given them the news. After several rounds of testing and investigative tracing, I've narrowed the suspect list down to 3 people. The first is Florent, Spina de Rosula's senior advisor.
Huh? Florent?
Yes, surprising, isn't it? He was one of the people Boss trusted the most, which also means that he was someone who understood Boss really well. Thanks to his position within Boss's innermost circle, he always knew our upcoming plans and could thus avoid capture this whole time. There's someone else like him too. Marcel, the head of Confrérie of Cabrières.
Uncle Marcel.
It's a guild in Poisson. Boss helped it to grow to its current size and prominence. In the beginning, they were only reselling some daily goods, but now they're one of the richest guilds around, with a lot of business connections in the city.
So, they're like a sister organization of Spina di Rosula?
Yes, you can say that. When we were fighting against the synth dealers, they provided us with plenty of support. It's a bit difficult to imagine someone using their own money to hunt down themselves.
The final suspect is Thierry, the man responsible for coordinating information between Spina di Rosula and the guards.
I think it's the second
Although
guy.
The guards mostly leave us to our own devices, there are still many activities we have to report to the local authorities. Since Thierry is always in the know about our current activities, he could theoretically always plan one step ahead.
I see. These are all people who I communicate with quite regularly. To think that the enemy we've been fighting against has been right next to me all along, among those I trust the most. It's almost too hard to believe.
If you want to investigate them, please take every precaution to not alert the quarry. Judging from our experience, the enemy is extremely cautious.
Of course. And thank you, Malus. You've provided us with a lot of great information.
You're too kind, my lady. I'm just doing my duty. And before I forget, proving Boss's innocence would also mean clearing him of blame in Jacques' death. After that incident, Jacques' wife and daughter were taken into the Spina's care. They still live in Poisson today. If it might help, you could also pay them a visit. I can make the necessary arrangements.
Aw, thank you so much, Malus. You really are the best.
A new case awaits, my dear partner.
Leave it to me.
I hope we can work together to uncover the truth and end this case once and for all.
It is settled, then. Please excuse me, and enjoy your conversation at your leisure.
Thank you for arranging everything for us, Malus.
Excuse me, miss. Do you need anything from us?
Hey, Navia's all quiet. This isn't like her at all.
Let's not bother her. She's thinking.
I'm sorry that I only came to visit after all this time. After what happened, I didn't know how I was supposed to face the two of you.
If it's about that, there's no need to apologize. After my husband died, Spina di Rosula sent us a lot of mora and support. I understood your guilt and apology to be genuine.
But aren't all of those things nothing compared to the loss of Jacques? I can understand the kind of pain that comes with losing a father so needlessly.
You don't understand at all.
I didn't know how to face you.
Young ass kid, get out of here.
Because I didn't know what I could possibly bring as a consolation gift. I know only the full truth could bring closure to you. And to all of us.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry. I appreciate the sentiment, but you don't have to carry all that guilt. On the matter regarding my husband, my daughter and I have more or less found our answer already.
Would you mind sharing it with me? I really can't believe that my father could ever bring himself to shoot Jacques.
I always knew that my husband's money was earned through others' suffering. He told me countless times that if he could turn back the clock, he would never go into the synth business again. He had many regrets, and felt that he took the idea of providing for his family too literally. For the longest time, he thought Mora was everything. So when Mr. Callis came to him with a proposal, he accepted it almost immediately. He tried to be as careful as he could, but even so, he was still found out by the higher-ups.
They found out about his betrayal?
Papa didn't say that exactly, but Papa did tell me that I should never be ungrateful.
Before he left that day, he told me that he had no choice. It was only later that I realized it was his final farewell to the two of us.
Does that mean someone ordered him to take out?
I don't know that for sure, but you could say that's the conclusion I eventually came to. Which is why I'm the one who should feel guilty. Callis had always taken great care of us, both when he was still alive and after he passed away. Even if he fired the shot that killed my husband, it was likely in self-defense. It is impossible for me to hate him for what he had done.
But Mama, why is Papa still the bad guy if he did the right thing? Papa always wanted to be a good man, so why did he have to do a bad thing in the end?
Well,
that's the way the world works.
Things aren't always as they seem. You still feel like your Papa was a good man, right?
Yeah. Papa was a really good man. The best in the whole world.
Then you should hold on to that. If a good man had to do a bad thing, then he must have had his reasons. Regardless of whether he left you a parasol or a sword. He must have done so to give you a better life.
Oh.
Thank you for everything you've told me. I will definitely find the truth. The current state of things is not something I'm willing to just sit back and accept.
Thank you. I'm very grateful to hear this from you. Even though your personality is quite different from your father's, your determination when you speak is really similar.
You really think so? That's the first time anyone said that to me.
Are you okay, Navia?
I'm fine. Don't worry. Let's investigate the three suspects next. Florent should be nearby, and we should be able to find Thierry and Uncle Marcel in the city.
I think it's Marcel. I'm
I'll
sorry.
I'll get myself together on the way. So please don't worry.
Greetings, boss. How may I be of assistance today?
I'm sure you've heard about what happened at the Opera House. Someone got turned into water right in front of us.
Yeah, I've heard. With something that dramatic, I'm sure journalists will milk it for all it's worth. And it'll be all the talk for the next several weeks.
It also reminded me, on the day that the incident happened with my father, it was raining outside, and we found some clothes left at the scene. After my partner here put the dots together for me, I feel like we should try to reopen his case. Can you do me a favor and try to recall what happened that night?
Let me think. Mr. Callis was feeling pretty upbeat that day. So he was drinking and bantering away with us at the table. After that, he told us that he wanted to go get some fresh air. So we let him go without thinking much of it. Who knew that we would hear two gunshots ring out right after? My first reaction was that Mr. Callis's life was in danger. So I grabbed my holster and made a mad dash toward the scene. But when I got there, it was already too late. Mr. Callis was standing over a dead body with a gun in his hands.
Oh, not the gun.
All we could do was look back and forth at each other, not knowing what to say.
So you also remember two gunshots then?
Indeed. The guard said that the first shot didn't hit anyone, while the second killed Jacques. But I've never really bought that explanation. Reason being, Mr. Callis had left his gun on the table. I even made sure to confirm that before running to the scene. But according to the guards, that doesn't mean he couldn't have had other guns on his person.
Wouldn't they have gotten
about the clothes left at the scene that you mentioned? Do you think there was a third person there who was turned into water?
At least from our perspective, my father had no reason to kill. So he would also have no reason to bring an extra gun with him. The gun he was holding probably belonged to Jacques, or a third person on the scene.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. So you're saying Mr. Callis ended up with the gun because he seized it from one of the other guys? But hold on. If that's what had happened, then why didn't he share the truth with any of us? He didn't even want to face the Oratrice machine, and chose instead to prove his honor in a duel. Did he lose all faith in the courts after seeing someone dissolve right in front of his eyes?
Yeah, probably.
About that, Malus told me a thing or two. So, I think I can understand why he committed to the duel. I'll tell you everything once the whole truth has been revealed.
I understand. Then, I'll leave Mr. Callis's honor in your hands, boss. And if I may just say one more thing. The whole Callis the Unfaithful epithet has been a thorn in my side since the day it was invented. Many people have laughed at me for still calling him Mr. Callis, even after so many years have passed. But it was Mr. Callis's trust that allowed me to rise through the ranks of Spina di Rasula and live the life I lead today. No matter what others might say, he'll always be the man I respect the most. And he'll always be my boss.
Don't worry. I will definitely find the truth. You and all our other comrades at the Spina deserve to know the truth as well.
Intel is just like futures. You gotta invest a lot before you can start earning.
Hey, Thierry! It's me!
Thierry!
Now, what brings you here, Miss Navia? I've heard that you made quite the name for yourself at the Opera House.
Oh, so you've caught news of that already.
Oh, okay. Hey, I'm also a member of the Guards, you know. The way you make it sound, people would think I was sent off to Poisson because I had done something wrong.
Are you sure there isn't a little bit of truth in that? Under normal circumstances, shouldn't you have been called back to the city already?
I mean, where I work is really up to me. Let's just say I enjoy the ambiance of Poisson. Callis did a fantastic job running the town, building Spina di Rasula from the ground up and clearing many obstructions in my way. It would be next to impossible for me to find a similarly easy but high-paying job in the city. Anyway, enough chit-chat. Are these two friends of yours? You, here for some formal business?
Yes. These two are my partners. What happened at the Opera House made us realize that Linny's case and my father's may be related. We're trying to reinvestigate the details of my father's old case.
Ah, I get it. You think there might be more to the case now that we know people can be dissolved into water, right? I was also flabbergasted when I first heard of it. If you want to go through the original files from your father's case, I can help you look for them.
That'd be much appreciated. Thank you. Actually, I have another question. Do you have the authority to dispatch Gardamex?
Of course. Without them, I couldn't possibly handle Poisson on my own. Why do you ask? We definitely can't use them to forcefully get more evidence for your father's case.
Well, you see, just recently, we were attacked by a horde of unnumbered Gardamex in the city. So, if you hypothetically wanted to do something against me, all you would need to do was get rid of the Mecha serial numbers and send them after me.
Then you think too highly of my abilities. Dispatching Mecha is very different from controlling them. If I had to make an analogy, when you order a dish, the chef will make it for you. You can ask the chef to cook, but not to massage your shoulders or carry your baggage. If you try to make unreasonable demands, the chef would just think you're out of your mind and ignore you completely. The same goes for me and my Gardamex. Removing a serial number is also not as easy as you might think. There are a lot of complex steps to it, and it's almost impossible to keep it a secret. So I can promise you, those Mecha were definitely private units. They're certainly not cheap. So, whoever their owner is must be super rich, powerful, or both. Now that you mention it, though, being in the synth business would definitely be profitable enough to afford this.
That's very true.
Oh, then you're officially in the clear, Thierry.
Oh, well, thank you for the vote of confidence, Navia.
He has no richness to him.
I'd like to wish you all the best with your investigation.
He's a broke boy.
I'll be staying in the city for a little while, so just come find me if you need any support from the guards.
All right, well, that leaves the uncle. I really genuinely think it's him. So, why else would he be the second introduced and then be the last one that we interrogate? Obviously, he's got to have some type of interesting thing about him.
Hello, how may I help you?
I'm here to see Marcel. Could you please let him know? You can just say Navia's looking for him.
Sure, I will let him know right away.
Navia, hello. Sorry to keep you waiting. I'm not as young as I used to be, so my legs are giving out a bit.
Oh, it's all right, Uncle Marcel. There's no need to stress. I just wanted to talk to you briefly about what happened in the Opera House. I'm sure you saw everything too, right?
Yes, I've never seen anything so strange.
Oh, you were at the Opera House too?
That's right. I went there with Navia to see the magic show. Who knew it would turn into a whole murder mystery? I also witnessed your marvelous sleuthing work. Quite impressive. To beat the Hydro Archon at her own game on her own turf, I can already imagine everyone in Fontaine discussing your exploits over a few glasses of wine.
Oh, Paimon doesn't want to become the talk of drunkards.
Apologies.
Rightfully so.
It's just how Fontaine is as a nation. Everyone loves drama and theatrics.
Uncle Marcel, you've also noticed that other thing, right? The fact that humans can dissolve in water?
Yes. I was reminded of your father's case right away. Is that what you're investigating now?
Exactly. I still don't have much solid proof, but I can sense that the other side has already begun to act.
Oh, and what makes you say that?
We were attacked on Araneus by some unnumbered Gardamex. And there was also an attempt to get me to drink water from the Primordial Sea. If not for the vigilance of my partner, I probably wouldn't even be here talking to you right now.
Oh, you're giving us too much credit. Wasn't it you who protected us?
Alas, it seems things are heating up again. The peace that Kallus sought so dearly will soon become a thing of the past. But rest assured, Navia, Poisson will always remain a safe haven for you. If you're scared, you can always return there. If anyone dares to lay their hands on you there, the Confrérie of Cabrières will use its funds to the last mora to bring them to justice.
Thank you, Uncle Marcel. But I don't intend to go into hiding.
I'm going to strike while the iron's hot. Do you have any new thoughts on my father's case?
About that. Sorry. The confrérie was responsible for that banquet, so I was out and about the whole time making sure things were running smoothly. I didn't even have the time to drink with the guests. Then I heard the sound of a gunshot, and the rest was history.
Oh, it's okay. No need to push yourself. We'll ask a-
Sounds good. Just let me know if you ever need Mora. All my wealth comes from Kallus' patronage and support. I'll spend however much it takes to clear his name.
He's still pretty sus to me. I don't know. I don't know how I'm expected to get up there.
We've talked to all three suspects, purely based on their conversations with me.
None of them sounded particularly suspicious.
None of them stood out as a suspect, but none of them were in... One of them wasn't really in the clear for me.
I suppose that's to be expected, though. If a single conversation's all that's needed to find them out, then my father wouldn't have needed to investigate the case for so many years. Anyway, even though we didn't make a breakthrough, let's still compile what we were able to find.
But where should we start? Ah, you're right! Flora mentioned that Kallus probably only ended up with a gun because of circumstance. That makes sense.
According to Jacques' family members, he already told them that he had been discovered, and that he had no choice before he left home that day. If I had to guess, he probably received an order from the synth boss to kill my father. Had he refused, he and his family's lives would have been forfeit.
So, Jacques fired the first shot?
Oh? And why is that?
Ooh, that's a good point. Jacques probably already knew that he was just being used as a tool for murder. And once he had completed his mission, he'd be of no more use to his boss.
So, what would make more sense from his perspective would be to turn his back on the order and seek protection from my father. Makes sense. But without evidence, that's still just a theory. Besides, Jacques, the attack from the Gardamex has been bothering me quite a bit as well. It's obvious that our enemy has become more antsy after the secret of the primordial seawater was revealed.
Do you think he knew, even then, that we'd follow this lead to the end?
Given everything that's happened since, it's quite possible. But who among the three suspects would have the ability to control privately owned Gardamex?
That would be...
Thierry, you say? But I didn't feel like he was lying when he was talking to us about the Mecha.
Yeah. Had he actually tampered with the Mecha, we'd be able to prove it with a simple check of the guard's inventory. If the Mecha were taken from the guards, it should be pretty easy to find out when and how that happened.
Maybe it was someone else. All right, we're going with my gut feeling. I think it's Marcel.
Uncle Marcel? My father did really trust him. And they worked together on a large number of projects. Maybe that's how he got to know Jacques. And with funds from the confrérie, he could also afford a large number of Gardamex. Still really hard for me to imagine, though. Also, wouldn't this mean he has been spending a whole lot of Mora and energy to fight his own synth business? Florent? It is true, but as Spina di Rosula's advisor, his work mostly deals with personnel and security. So
you're saying he's too broke to afford a Mecha army?
Exactly. He can't. And even if he could, I don't think he would be able to dispatch a whole group so quickly. Who could it be?
Maybe it was someone else. I think... I think it's Marcel.
You know, if you think everything through, Uncle Marcel is indeed the most suspicious
Thank
of them
you.
All.
I'm smart. You are not. Everyone else.
Most
goodbye.
Didn't know about the people turning into water thing when he narrowed it down to these three, did he?
Malus has always been very reliable, and his judgment of others' trustworthiness has been fair and well considered. When he laid out his case for the three, the rationale he gave me made a lot of sense as well. The suspect is knowledgeable about the Spina's internal affairs, has the means to dispatch Mecca to assassinate us, and possesses significant intellect and foresight.
That guy just run.
Even if I don't want to believe it, I'm starting to see how things could all tie back to Uncle Marcel.
He is someone who is very close to you, which would make sense. He does have... He technically does have the motive, too.
Well, we still have another trump card on top of all the theorizing and speculating.
Synth production base.
Yes. Malus did say that charging straight in there would be extremely risky. But we don't have any other options right now. We need far more solid proof before we can hope to go charging in on our enemy.
Navia, here you are. Oh, I've been
looking
for you.
That's you were running down there. I saw you.
Huh? Aren't you the guy from the guards? Did something happen?
Yeah. News came from Aranias just after you left. We've got another trial on our hands.
Wasn't that place built specifically for holding trials? What's so newsworthy about this one?
Another female experience.
But they said the person they're putting on trial is a Fatui Harbinger.
What the fuck did he do? Dude, you just got here and you're already on trial?
What? Is that someone you know?
Yeah, he can die.
We know him. Maybe even a little too well.
Well, he's been accused of being the true culprit behind the serial disappearances case. It's absurd, don't you think?
It is absurd because of the most part that he was in Liwa with us, so honestly he couldn't have made anyone disappear via that way. However, he doesn't really have any motive to do so.
Wait, how? None of our investigations have had anything to do with him.
That's what I thought was strange about it, so I came to tell- If the charge against him stands, then it'll be next to impossible to get the guards to support any of our planned investigations.
Right. Because they'll think they've already found the culprit.
Yeah. And it'll be a lot harder then to clear Mr. Callus's name.
I understand. Well, partner, what do you think we should do? We still haven't found any conclusive evidence. Huh? Split up? What do you mean? Just as expected of my partner. Since this is a trial about the serial disappearances case, the culprit's attention will be focused on Aranias, leaving his home base wide open. You're right. This is our best opportunity. All right then, let's do this. I'll stall them at the Opera House and charge Marcel as the true culprit. I won't have any chance of making that charge stick, though, unless we find more evidence. It'll be up to you to make it back in time and hand the decisive evidence to me.
We'll help you, just like you helped us in Linny's trial.
Demoiselle, please allow us to accompany you.
I'm ready.
Ah, Malus, Silver, when did you two get here?
We heard that you'll be leaving Poisson and figured that you might require our assistance.
No, she's
it's
so adorable.
Your confidence will be bolstered with the two of us by your side.
Thank you so much. Then, let's make haste for Aranias. Paimon, Traveler, I'll see you at the Opera House.
See you then!
See, I'm smart enough to figure out. Marcel was obviously dubious from the very beginning.
For Aranias, we should also get going. The location has already been marked on the map, so let's head over. Huh. According to Malus's info, the synth production base is underwater. Let's go and try to find the entrance.
Oh my god, Barbara actually looks so natural swimming in the water. I didn't realize that.
That leads to the synth production base. It sure doesn't seem out of the ordinary at all. Ah, you're right. An important place like this is bound to have a ton of protective. Navia's probably arguing up a storm right now to stall for us.
Oh boy. Child, what you do?
It would appear that I must repeat my question again, Mr. Tartaglia. Do you accept the charge that you are the true culprit behind the serial disappearances case?
Obviously not!
To be perfectly honest, I don't understand your country's complicated court system, or the reason why I'm being charged with something I've never even heard of. However, I did hear that people who have been charged can choose to participate in a duel to clear their name. Is that right? In which case, as long as I accept the charge, I can have an all-out fight with that champion duelist, Clorend, right? I've got to admit, that's one of the most enticing offers I've ever received. When I privately sparred with her last time, she was obviously holding back. Real disappointing.
Hey! Don't you understand? You're currently the prime suspect for a major case. This isn't the place for you to be looking for fights.
Oh? Sounds like the Hydro Archon wants to lecture me on the ways of the Opera House. Then why don't you duel me too? I'm the kind of student that learns best in the heat of battle.
No. That's not what I meant.
You would die if you went up against him, huh?
The communication with the defendant is going poorly, and we have made very little progress. In that case, let me explain everything from the very beginning again. The goal of this trial is to determine the culprit behind the serial disappearances case.
That case had nothing to do with him! You've got the wrong man!
Huh? What's going on? Why is she interjecting again?
Because she was actually involved this time.
One of the Fatui Harbingers.
Miss Navia, this is the second time you've interrupted the court proceedings. I only tolerated your behavior last time because you were able to provide the court with a key eyewitness. But that was an exception rather than standard court protocol. I can very well charge you with contempt of court for your interjections.
Oh, please. Did you ever think I had any respect for this place's pointless theatrics? We can put that discussion aside for now. I'm not here to argue with you. I'm here to charge the true culprit behind the serial disappearances case. And if my charges prove true, then Tartaglia here will be proven innocent by default, correct?
Oh, a young lady has charged in and offered to clear my name. How fascinating. Well, I'd gotten half bored to death by all these rules and procedures anyway.
So I'll take you up on that offer. Oh.
So, Your Honor, is there nothing else for me to do now?
You may take a seat for now in the audience, but that doesn't mean the suspicions against you have been lifted.
Fucking dumbasses.
Now then, who is the person you would like to charge instead?
Marcel!
That person is...
Marcel!
Marcel! The head of Confrérie of Cabrières!
Huh? What Confrérie? Never heard of them in my life!
I've heard of them, but weren't they Spina di Rosula's sister organization?
Oh, is this going to be a friends-to-enemies type situation?
Please let me remind you, Miss Navia, that charging someone is an incredibly serious matter. Committing to the charge also means taking on the legal responsibilities associated with it.
I am doing this.
If the charge fails, depending on the circumstances, you may also be charged with the crime of making a false accusation. Knowing this, do you still wish to charge this man?
Didn't?
Yes, I
do. Wait. You can be charged with a crime of making a false accusation, right? Then what the... Where's the trial for the Fontaine Archon already? Come on.
In that case, I declare the charge to be valid. Miss Navia and attorneys, please take your places on the court. Members of the guards, please contact Mr. Marcel right away so that he may stand trial. Mr. Marcel, you will not require an attorney. Is that correct?
Apologies. It all just happened so quickly. I still haven't figured out what's going on. I think an attorney won't be necessary. This is probably just a misunderstanding between me and Navia.
Very well. In that case, since both sides have now arrived, Miss Navia, please present your charges.
I would like to take everyone back to 3 years ago, to the case of Callus the Unfaithful. Only through elucidating what really happened in that case can we connect all the dots for the serial disappearances case.
Navia, do you really think that I was the one who killed your father?
Not directly.
Why would I do that? Callus was my benefactor, and remember, both you and I only ran to the scene when we heard the sound of a gun. If that's enough to make me a suspect, wouldn't that make everyone at that banquet a suspect as well?
I think there's no point in getting into the specifics right now. The audience doesn't even have the big picture yet. Even I'm struggling to remember some details of that case. Exactly correct, Your Honor. I must refresh everyone's memory about that case before I can explain my charge and reasoning.
I see. In which case, I will recount the findings about that case as originally recorded by Maison Gardienage.
Oh, we're going up against him? Oh,
hell. On the day of the murder, Spina di Rosula hosted a large banquet in a countryside estate owned by the Confrérie of Cabrières. During the banquet, all attending guests heard two gunshots from the courtyard. When the guests arrived at the scene, they found the primary suspect, Callus, holding a gun, while his acquaintance, Jacques, lay dead from a gunshot wound. The guards' investigation did not recover any other firearms from the scene. As a result, they concluded that the suspect's first shot must have missed, while the second must have taken Jacques' life. The suspect did not dispute this conclusion, and also declined to defend himself in court. Instead, he chose to prove his innocence through a duel. Callus was defeated by champion duelist Clarand in the ensuing duel, and soon succumbed to the injuries. These are the known facts about the case.
Second one seems the most feasible to refute right now.
The one with the motive to kill was Jacques, not my father. And even so, Jacques still had no reason to pull the trigger. In truth, the third person shot Jacques first, and was shot in turn by my father when my father seized the gun from him. After that, turned the third person into water.
Girl, I called that 20 minutes ago. Get your stuff together. Even I said that.
Thank you for the summary, Your Honor. Of course, the guard's conclusion appeared quite sensible to us at the time. However, we should revisit the case now that we've gained new information about the abilities of water from the Primordial Sea. The testimony of the victim's family confirms that Jacques had thoughts of assassinating Callus when he set out for the banquet. However, in the end, he reconsidered, and instead shared everything with Callus, hoping to seek the latter's protection. Unfortunately for Jacques, the true culprit had already considered this possibility, and had sent out another assassin.
This assassin first shot Jacques, then turned to shoot Callus, only for Callus to wrestle the gun from him and kill him instead.
Okay, fine. We'll go with this one then. Damn. The water's gotta go somewhere. I know that.
Was found at the scene. The guards once believed they were used by Jacques as a costume to disguise himself. But now, since it was raining that day, the culprit was confident that they could use the rain to wash away all traces of their dissolved accomplice. Realizing this, the true culprit caused the hired assassin to dissolve into water, leading everyone to believe Callus was responsible for Jacques' murder. This is the true version of events.
Ah, so that's what happened.
For those of you who haven't played Tears of Themis, I advise you, this is the exact type of shit you go through. I just guess. I don't even look through the clues at that point. It's not worth going through every single thing. Better to guess, get it right by mistake. It's okay, you don't get any backlash. It's just like Genshin.
Wait,
so
you're telling me something as dangerous as water from the Primordial Sea has been used for all these years?
What a great theory. It also explains Callus's and Jacques' respective motives. I guess they didn't shoot each other after all.
Mr. Marcel, you are the one being charged with the crime. You should provide a rebuttal if you wish to prove your innocence.
Ah, but I think I agree with everything Navia just said. In fact, there was nothing in her speech that directly implicated me.
Then, may I ask some questions? In my opinion, we primarily need to determine two things. One, do you have the evidence to back up your claims?
I'm afraid not. At least not at this very moment.
Boo! If you don't have any evidence, you should just go home!
I may not have the evidence with me, but I know where I could go to collect it. If we look up the deserted clothes against a record of people who went missing around the same time, we should be able to find a match. Considering the serial disappearances case, the guards probably kept careful records of all missing persons from around that time, regardless of age or gender.
That makes sense to me. Monsieur Nouvellet, I would consider this to be a reasonable investigative direction.
Huh. Why do I feel like Farina's acting a little differently today?
Maybe she's scared of embarrassing herself again?
Love you, guy. I love you, Silver.
After charging an innocent citizen in the last trial.
My second question has to do with the ensuing duel. If the truth is indeed as you described, then why didn't Mr. Callus explain himself in court? If he had testified that a person had been dissolved, he could have at least mounted a defense.
Because no one would believe him. There is that in particular.
I've thought about this too, and the answer is actually pretty simple. He felt there were things that were more important to him. The dissolving power of water from the Primordial Sea is an important secret for the true culprit of the serial disappearances case. My father could have exposed it for all to see, but he chose to take it to the grave. At that time, Spina di Rosula was in dire straits, and his reputation had already been shattered. He had no guarantee that going forward with the truth would allow the culprit to be brought to justice. What was certain, however, was that it would paint a gigantic target on my back.
Boss once told me that Demoiselle had already been selected as the next target of the serial disappearances case.
What? If the secret had gotten out, the culprit would have fought an all-out war with Espina right there and then. I wouldn't have been the only one in danger. All of us would have stood to lose our lives. Of course, the guards might eventually figure out the truth of the matter and determine that we were in the right. But what good would that do? How can a hollow verdict protect anyone? Had this opera house ever given my father any kind of confidence in its brand of justice, Spina di Rosula would have had no reason to exist.
But by staying silent, we retain the ability to deter our opponents and continue the stalemate. I was able to become Spina di Rosula's president, which made me harder to target, as well as giving me more time to grow and learn. And once I have figured out the truth and stepped up to the challenge, I will do what this opera house cannot, and restore my father's truth and honor back to him.
So, you mean to say, your father intended to die in the duelist's ring?
Yes.
That's right.
To protect.
Do you have any proof?
You need proof?
All you need is to ask his opponent, Clarand. I don't need your apology, your guilt, or your support from the shadows. You don't have to do anything for my sake. But since he entrusted his will to you, Clarand, you should tell us the truth about his sacrifice.
During the duel, did you believe that Kallus was intending to die?
Yes.
Yes, I did. As a champion duelist, I've fought many battles and taken a countless number of dishonored lives. In my line of work, I've seen all kinds of people give their all for the faintest hope to continue living. Some were determined, others passionate, and some even manic and twisted. Just one look and I can tell if a duelist is hoping to live or if they're looking to die. I hereby swear on my name and honor as a champion duelist that Mr. Kallus never intended to leave the ring alive.
Since that's your testimony, I have no more questions. It appears there really are good grounds to reopen this case.
I concur. However, Miss Navia, you still have not explained the link between your father's case and the serial disappearances
case. I'm still waiting on that evidence to arrive.
What she said was fascinating, but kind of beside the point.
Wait. Weren't they just talking about the serial disappearances case?
Of course, Your Honor. The two cases are connected via a matter of timing. In my father's case, the culprit intended to kill both Jacques and Kallus. As a result, they planned to act after hearing two gunshots. And, at the end of Linny's trial, the culprit also only dissolved the victim in front of everyone because they were at risk of being identified.
Yeah.
The culprit could only time their actions so precisely if they were already at the scene. Coincidentally, Marcel attended both the banquet and the trial.
So that's why you suspected me. Even after hearing your reasoning, I still can't help but find it a little preposterous. I'm used to it, though. You've always been an impulsive and sentimental child, Navia. It's one of your most endearing traits.
You're not helping yourself here, Uncle.
No need to appeal to pathos.
I won't try to refute your points one by one, but even if everything you just said was true, can you prove that I was the only person present at both events?
Yes.
On top of that, does a person have to be physically present to control the timing? Can't someone remotely monitor the place?
Oof. Don't know what she can say to that.
I know that even with that, you might still think you can reduce the list of suspects with some further investigations until I'm the only one left on the list. Alas, who won't feel at least a little hurt by an accusation of murder from a girl you see as your own daughter? But if I were to dismiss this completely, you'd also think I'm not being considerate of your feelings. Ah, well. Let Uncle Marcel teach you another lesson.
Yeah, he's definitely guilty.
Do you know what the biggest flaw in your reasoning is?
What?
I suppose you're gonna tell me anyways.
It's timing again. I'm a businessman by trade. From that standpoint, there's no reason for me to kidnap young women. It's a high-risk action with nothing to gain.
You sure?
In addition, I left my home in Snezhnaya when I was young to come to Poisson and work in some trade. My business only thrived when I received Kallus's patronage. But the disappearances began before I ever stepped foot in Fontaine.
It just means you were an accomplice in that.
I do apologize, demoiselle. This was my mistake.
No, it's not your fault. I'm sure he had come prepared.
Is there anything else you'd like to say? Would you like to check the date of my first business license against the first known case of the serial disappearances? You can also take a look at my border entry records, or ask my friends and family when I left Snezhnaya for the first time. Could those records and testimonies do something to appease the unspeakable anguish in your heart?
Oh, seems like she got the wrong guy.
At this rate, Navia will be convicted for falsely accusing him.
I think you've done a superb job of dissecting your father's feelings.
No, he's still guilty. I'm sorry.
But aren't you going against all of his wishes and expectations right now?
Nope.
He wished for you to become more rational, collected, and conscientious, instead of dwelling only on your own feelings. Once you've learned to be more considerate of others' feelings, and to stop rushing headlong into things, you'd have met most of his expectations.
Objection!
This isn't just about me, and it never has been. The biggest difference between me and the rest of the victims is that I still have the ability to search for the truth, while that same agency has long been taken from them. The people whose families were destroyed by synth abuse, the people who lost their loved ones to the serial disappearances, and the people who suffered tragic ends due to their sense of justice. Many people's images are flashing before my eyes. I'm sure some are coming to those of you in the audience as well. And whose image do you see, Marcel? Is it a man named Vache?
Vache? Oh,
so you do know that name?
I'm merely surprised you'd suddenly say the name of someone I've never even heard of.
I was waiting for you to say that.
Oh. I love how she looks in the water. She looks so natural. It's so pretty. Who wants to play mermaids with me? Nadia doesn't look as natural. I think Xianfei looks kind of natural. I think Barbara still looks the most natural. Toma too. He looks kind of natural to water. Probably because he almost drowned it, but that's... It's a mere connection. Dude, this is gonna give me some, like, motion sickness or something.
Everyone hold hands! I'll protect us.
Supporting fire! Fire it up! Check this!
Whoa! The floor is going up! Is it because of this mechanism in the middle? That guy really prepared a lot of stuff for this place.
Pretty interesting.
Paimon thinks we need to go up, but Paimon doesn't see a way.
Oh my god.
Maybe we'll find a hidden mechanism that'll show us the way up.
I did not expect that, bro. Get your butt back over here. I don't even know what I'm supposed to be doing. Dude. I don't know what the fuck I'm supposed to be doing. I don't know what the fuck I'm supposed to... what am I doing? Create... holding it down will continuously... oh! Hold on. What the fuck? Dude! No, I don't know what I'm doing! What the fuck am I supposed to do? Bro, the court case is already over at this point. Like, how the hell? Traveler, help me. Stay still, you bitch. What the fuck does my- what the fuck am I supposed to do? Bruh! What the fuck am I supposed to do? Bruh. Oh, that- I give up, dude. I am about to surrender myself. Ten minutes alone just on that part. Court case is over. Everyone go home.
The water level is rising. Now we can swim to the top. But this is still a ways away from where we need to go. Make yourselves at home. Hey, let's dance.
Yeah. Don't get too close. Sit.
Yeah. Time for your arraignment.
It's okay, my Yanfei is a slay. My Yanfei loves this. She dies for this.
everything.
I'll protect us. Huh. Yeah.
Here's backup. Fire it up.
Everyone hold hands.
Yeah. Huh. Yeah.
My Yenfei loves reactions. Mama, I'm a criminal.
After all that, we finally made it to the innermost sanctum. Though, as expected, the mastermind isn't here. That's right. Then let's hurry up and find some evidence so we can get back to the opera house and...
So we gotta scroll through things.
What's all this? Pink accessories, a hair tie, a necklace, even a makeup box.
So, women's possessions? There's a name?
Oh, Paimon sees it too, but... Why are... Huh? You mean the girls from the... And then they were turned into... And all the boxes of things... These names. That means... Whoa.
That's a lot.
There's so much synth here. And so many bottles of ingredients that probably just contain the waters of the primordial sea.
Can we take pictures with a camera? Can a camera even work the we've swimmed in water?
Ready to drink? Stock sample? Huh, whoa! There's even fruit-flavored synth? Yep, it's super obvious. Oh, look! There's an important-looking basin over here! And it's full of water!
Water from the primordial sea?
That means this is where they make all the synth! If you dilute it with normal water, you'll get synth! But the pure stuff can dissolve a human! Paima will take notes on this incriminating evidence!
Yeah, this is some Tears of Themis stuff.
Let's see what's written here! Nothing escapes Detective Paimon's eyes! Callus, Navia's father. Oh, this seems to be an investigation. Yep, it's about finding someone to assassinate Jacques and Callus. This should prove the existence of the third person, right? We still have not determined the exact content of the key information Callus has passed on to certain members of his organization. The old dog's a real menace to deal with. Even if he abides by the promise he's made to us, he will still have the upper hand. He can act whenever he wants to make our lives miserable. The only option left is to remove him from the picture entirely. I concur. Let's send someone to kill him. He won't declare war as long as we don't touch Navia. Oh, seems like we've got a bunch of correspondence between the higher-ups. They're all just so evil.
We did that. I think we're finished.
What's this over here? Looks like some kind of place for... Experiment number 16 aims to verify Jacob Ingold's research conclusions on the primordial sea, and use his theory as a foundation. The experiment was a failure. No individual managed to resurface from the water from the primordial sea. Female specimens 22, 23, and 24 were dissolved.
Do we have to have a warrant for this stuff, by the way? We are not the police.
Sorry, Traveler. Paimon will try her best. It's just that Paimon's never read something so scary before. How could someone write something that terrible in such a matter-of-fact tone? You read the rest. Paimon's too scared to keep going. So that's why he did all of these experiments. Wait, did he really think he'd be able to find a way just by dissolving people over and over? That's just insane! Huh? Isn't that the name you heard by the fountain? Paimon thought he was an eyewitness in the serial disappearances case. You mean Fache is the one who did all of these... experiments? So that's it! Vache was no victim, but personally took his lover and... No, that's not it either! If that's the case, why would he want people to resurface from the water? In any case, Paimon will write it all down. Looked at almost everything here, and it seems like our theories were spot on, but...
Who's really Vache?
Yeah,
Vache.
We haven't found anything that reveals his true identity. No wonder even Nervalette wasn't able to find anything. Whoever it is probably destroyed everything to do with that name a long time ago. That way, even if we bring all this back to the opera, we won't be able to identify the true culprit. Sure thing. Paimon won't admit defeat to this guy either! You take that side and Paimon will take... Ugh. Nothing at all! And Paimon can't even find snacks either!
I'm sure they would be laced with lethal poison.
Whoa, really? Let Paimon see! Vignier. Isn't that Vache's lover's name? Then you found her aww. It's just a normal diary chronicling their love story. She was so sweet.
No!
Oh, Paimon feels even worse for her now.
See, that's what you get for wanting to have kids. Honestly, like, I'm sorry. Just kidding.
So many! A whole page's worth! But they're all crossed out. The final name she decided on was Marcel. Wait, but Marcel's pretty old. Has this case been going on for so long that he's Fache and Vignier's grown son?
We gotta fucking run. Ladies and gents.
And whose image do you see, Marcel? Is it a man named Vache?
Huh.
Oh, so you do know that name.
I'm merely surprised you'd suddenly say the name of someone I've never even heard of.
I was waiting for you to say that.
Navia! We're back!
As expected of my partner. I just knew you'd return in the nick of time.
Just how often do you intend to flout the rules of this court?
It's all right, Monsieur Nervalette. Given their confidence, I expect they've found the crucial evidence.
It say you never heard of Vashier. However, he is your son.
But the truth of it, Marcel, is that you've always been Vashier.
Huh?
We've investigated your lair and we already know everything! After your lover, Veneer, was dissolved, you kept abducting young women to experiment on the hopes of bringing her back to you! You even created Marcel as a new identity and destroyed all records of your past as Vashier!
So that's it. Even the villains in opera performances rarely go that far. And with that, Marcel's motive has now been established.
This information regarding your past also dismantles your prior timing defense. Well, Marcel, do you know where you went wrong?
Yeah.
You fixated your gaze on the lover that passed away, instead of paying attention to the living people around you. So, you never noticed how we changed, or how we grew as individuals.
You also never understood Boss's real expectations for his daughter.
Or our determination to see things through.
Your determination?
Mr. Marcel, please speak up now if you would like to defend yourself. Otherwise, the trial will move on to the next stage.
Do you really think I wanted to do any of this?
Well,
pay attention to you. What for? Have you ever paid attention to me? Ever empathized with my pain? Ever known how it feels to watch the love of your life dissolve right in front of your eyes? No one helped me.
No one even believed me.
All those decades ago, even the officers from the Maison Gardiennage were laughing at me. They said there's no way a human being can turn into water. So I must have gone mad from grief. Vigner's death was brushed away by all of you as if it didn't matter at all. Well, now you know, don't you? Ha! Well, it's too late now. All those who were dissolved are gone forever. You only have yourselves to blame. You set up this ornate opera house in pursuit of your so-called justice. Your beloved drama, while turning a blind eye to the suffering of the people. Veneer is dead. We promised each other that we would always be together. Wherever she goes, I will follow. But I'm not from this blasted place. So I can't be dissolved.
That's
why. No matter what I do.
Is he intending to poison himself? He's taking himself some nice drugs.
Do you all see? I can't go. I can't follow. So if I can't go where she is, what choice do I have but to try to bring her back? I did all of that. And in the end, that accursed Callus still got the better of me. I spent my entire life living on pins and needles. Only to get stabbed by his idiot daughter at the very end.
The suspect is exhibiting signs of mental distress. Guards, please restrain him.
Don't touch me! Don't anybody come near me! I still need to save Vigner. I promise.
We have a message from the person at the fountain.
Vigner. Vigner. Please, Vigner. Don't think badly of me. All I want to do is fulfill our promise.
At this point, the verdict of this trial is clear. With Mr. Marcel's conviction, the charges against Mr. Tartaglia no longer have any basis.
Woohoo, I'm free!
I was in a bad mood, but after a show like that, I'm actually feeling pretty good.
Traveler, please submit all the evidence you have collected to the guards so that I might review and summarize the truth behind the serial disappearances case.
Lord have mercy.
The man now known as Marcel was originally named Vashier and worked as an adventurer with his partner and lover Vigner. During an underwater expedition, Vigner accidentally came into contact with water from the primordial sea and was dissolved in front of Vashier as a result. Vashier learned of the primordial water's existence through the work of others and began to kidnap young women for research, with the goal of discovering a method to restore Vinyere back to life. To cover his tracks, he invented the new alias of Marcel and began to operate a business in Poisson. During the course of his research, Vacher discovered that a diluted concoction of water from the primordial sea can induce feelings of euphoria, and began to manufacture and market synth. However, as he accumulated wealth to fund his continued research and expanded the scope, he came into conflict with Spina di Rasula. After exchanging blows with Spina di Rasula for many years, Vacher decided to assassinate their president, Callus, at a banquet. Although the assassination did not go as Vacher expected,
my God, I love having this man in my ears.
The murder suspect by dissolving the assassin he sent to the scene. And just recently, Vacher attempted to frame Linny as the culprit of the serial disappearances case using a similar method. However, his attempt to frame Linny failed, and the power of water from the primordial sea became public knowledge. This case also exposed enough of Vacher's machinations that he was eventually successfully charged in court. Thus concludes the enigmatic history of the serial disappearances case, with the truth revealed to all. The Oratrice will now deliver the final verdict regarding the charges against Mr. Vacher.
Tell us, innocent or guilty?
According to the judgment of the Oratrice Mécanique d'Analyse Cardinale, Mr. Vacher is...
not guilty?
Guilty.
Okay, I was gonna say. Thank you. Bless.
Guards, take Vacher away.
Good. It's what he deserves.
With that, the serial disappearances case is over now.
We really just witnessed history. Who would have thought the true culprit would be such a polite and well-spoken guy?
Yippee! We have... He's hurt so many innocent people, and now he's finally getting what he deserves. Huh? Are you okay?
Navia?
Demoiselle, you were absolutely brilliant.
The day our late boss had always hoped for has finally come. You can rest easy now, knowing justice has been served.
Yeah. Yeah. It's finally over.
Oh.
It's all thanks to you guys.
Navia!
My partner. See, Papa? Spina di Rosula still doing well with me at the helm.
Well now, hasn't this been a most delicious piece of drama? The villain has been caught, justice has been served, past wrongs have been righted, and it's a big ol' happy ending. Since it's been such a great show, I'll just let the false accusations against me slide. Either way, I've still got some business to attend to. So, if you'll excuse me...
Wait a minute.
Please wait just one moment, Mr. Tartaglia.
What now? None of this has anything to do with me.
According to court protocol, since this trial was initiated due to a charge against you, a verdict must also be made regarding the initial charge before the trial can conclude.
Oh, come on. Is this really necessary? Haven't you already caught the real criminal? Isn't it time for side characters like me to exit stage left?
Oh my God,
Please respect the laws of Fontaine. This has always been the rule.
All right, but this sure is a lot of hassle. All I need to do is stand over there, right? Let's just get this over with.
Through evidence presented in the public trial that was just held, it has been established that Mr. Tartaglia has no direct connection to the serial disappearances case.
However,
the guilty party has been identified, and thus it is logical to suppose Mr. Tartaglia is innocent of the charges.
However,
we now turn to the Oratrice Mécanique d'Analyse Cardinale to render the final verdict on the charges.
Is it gonna say that he's guilty?
According to the judgment of the Oratrice Mécanique d'Analyse Cardinale, Mr. Tartaglia is guilty.
What? Hello?
Hey, that's not funny. Didn't you just say I'm supposed to be innocent? What's with this verdict? Is your justice machine malfunctioning?
Huh? This has never happened before. The Oratrice actually returned a different verdict from the Chief Justice.
I mean, have you ever heard of an innocent Fatui Harbinger? Do you think the Oratrice might have just convicted him on
That's what I'm thinking, but I don't know.
Weren't the charges about the serial disappearances case? No matter what else he's guilty of, it shouldn't affect the verdict in this case, right?
The judgment of the Oratrice Mechanique d'Analyse Cardinale is, by law, the final verdict of the court. We must accept the guilty verdict.
Oh, hell no, you're not taking me alive.
Please take the suspect into custody per court protocol.
Excuse me. No. Oh, hell no, you're gonna have to take me. Fuck that.
So this is how justice is done in Fontaine. What a joke. You've got your rules.
And so do I. I believe in your innocence. Child. Oh, never mind.
I'm sorry. If you have been wronged, we will find the truth. But the rules of the court must be upheld.
What the fuck? Excuse me, sir.
Apologies. This is also the first time I've encountered such a situation. However, according to the rules established at the conception of Fontaine's court system, the Oratrice's judgment is the final verdict.
That literally just undid all of the work that we did. Court procedure.
As for why the Oratrice arrived at the conclusion it did, you should probably ask someone more knowledgeable than me.
Why are you looking at me? I had nothing to do with it! I don't know what happened there either. Hey, stop staring at me!
What does Lady Farina mean by that?
She says she has no idea either, but that's impossible. Didn't she create the Oratrice herself?
Yeah, so are the verdicts reliable or not? Can results like this really be called justice?
My dearest citizens.
Did you really think we'd allow an incorrect verdict to be handed out in this court? Did you really believe that the judgment could be mistaken or be the result of some sort of random mishap? Don't tell me. You thought even I had been blindsided by the Oratrice's result.
But the way she looked just now, it was pretty obvious she had no idea what was going on.
However, given the state of things, I shall give you an explanation. Everything that just took place, including my supposed shock,
I'm gonna start throwing shit at people.
Was an elaborate performance, with every action meant to stir up drama.
If someone hand me a fucking tomato, I'm gonna throw it at this bitch.
Of course, for every performance, there is a script. Everything has unfolded exactly as I expected from the very beginning. As the embodiment of the very concept of justice, the Oratrice shall never render an arbitrary judgment! If you thought Child had nothing to do with the serial disappearances case, it is only because you've been blinded by the superficial appearance of innocence.
He has siblings. Everything There's no way he'd kidnap any woman.
The danger he poses.
He literally has a sister. He has no motive to do so.
All shall be revealed in time. You will come to understand my noble intentions
as well as the absolute correctness of the Oratrice's verdict. Now, having said that, although I hate to leave things hanging in suspense, it is now
Toodaloo.
Time for this performance to end. As the lead actress, I shall be the first to take my leave. Toodaloo!
So she chose to make her escape after all, did she?
So you're saying we shouldn't put much stock into what she just said?
She probably just put on that performance to save face. As for the truth, it's unlikely that she actually has any idea. However, please be assured that I will continue to investigate this case in a personal capacity. Just as I promised, if the judgment has been incorrect, we will do our utmost to clear his name.
All right. Even though we feel pretty badly for him, we'll take your word for it for now. After all, he's done plenty of bad stuff. So he should have known he'd go to prison someday, right?
You just said that instead of... Okay. Oh my god. Damn, never mind. Jesus Christ, bro. He's still a tall man. He's taller than Toma. What the hell? Oh wait, he's wearing heels. Toma's not. Wait, could Toma be taller than him? Depends. No, I don't think so. I think he's still taller. Hello. Just want to take a look. Oh my god, sir.
Don't get too close.
Yeah. Yo-ho.
Oh, Monsieur Nervalette. That power you showed when you took him down. Who are you really?
I'm the Chief Justice of Fontaine, of course. If officers of the law lack the strength and capability to enforce it, then it makes a mockery of justice.
True that. Objection!
What are you doing? Quick, stop him!
Traveler! Hey! Traveler!
Marcel! What are you doing over here?
Stop resisting arrest! Cease, or we'll add another charge to the list!
No, wait! I just want to ask the Traveler something. I'm not looking to run away. Please, just let me ask this one small thing.
Go on.
Oh boy.
Thank you.
I'm gonna quickly grab a thing of water. I'm thirsty.
It was gonna be so hot outside, dude.
I can't. I'm sorry, I think I forgot to mute, but that's okay. Alright, we're back. I have water, so now I'm gonna stay nice and cool. I also messed with the AC because it turned up. Turned itself off, so.
I was being led away when I finally realized something. Where did you first hear the name Vache?
The water fountain.
I erased all records of that name. So, Unless...
Are you still trying to prove your innocence? Give it up. You've already been convicted.
Met her.
Really? You did? You're sure? You met her? But how could that be? How did you manage to do it? The Fountain of Lucene? Then she's been so close to me all along. And I just never... Please give me a chance to talk to her again. Just let the Traveler take me to the fountain to see her one last time. This is the last request I'll ever make in my life. You can do whatever you want to me afterwards. I don't care.
Oh.
What? Give an inch and you want to take a mile? Do you think serial killers get to make requests like that?
Think of it as his last meal. He'll have water from the Lucene fountain.
This request, is it worth as much to you as your life?
Mm-hmm.
Of course! Wait, no. It's worth even more than my life.
Humans, will they betray the instinct to live just to satisfy spiritual needs?
Okay.
Very well. I will grant your request.
Dragon Bestie, it's not that deep. Don't dig into it.
I fear that.
I will go with him. You do not need to worry about any escape.
In that case, I shall leave him in your most capable hands, Chief Justice.
Thank you. Thank you, Your Honor.
Na 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 ma na ma na ma ma. Because I'm a be bad boy. Oh, wait, no, I can get copyrighted for that. I mean...
Is this the place? You said she's here, but what do I need to do to see her?
Yeah, and even Paimon could hear her after drinking that thing. Didn't you just drink a lot of it on the stage as well? Oh, in that case...
Vashe.
Ah!
Yes, that's it! So you heard it too!
Vinyere, it's me! It's me, Vashe!
Vashe? Vashe!
I'm here! Where are you, Vinyere? I'm coming for you! I'm finally here for you!
Hey, wait! Be careful! Hey, wait!
Vinyere! Is that you? It's me,
Jesus
Vashe.
Christ.
Vinyere!
Vashe? Why did you come? Didn't I say? You don't need to look for me. You look a lot older than I remember. How long has it been?
It's been more than 20 years. I've suffered for over 20 years since the day you left. All this time, only the thought of bringing you back has kept me alive. Nothing else mattered to me. I must be dreaming. Who would have thought I'd get the chance to tell you all of my feelings like this? Vinyere, you are my everything. I really don't know how I could live without you.
But Vashe, if you ask me, this world would be better off without you.
So true, bestie.
What are you
your
saying?
Stuff. Tell your stuff.
You. I would have finished my law degree and probably become a top-tier attorney one day. If not for you, I would have continued to pursue my love of the arts, and my works would have been displayed in the Palais Mermonia itself. If not for you, I would at least have been able to take care of my mother. And she would not have grown old and died alone, with nothing but the tears on her cheeks. It's all because of your selfishness, Vashe. It's all because of you.
You... Wait, you are not...
You're right. I am not Vinyere. I am the sacrifices. Every woman who died by your hand has our bodies dissolved. Our consciousnesses flowed back to the primordial sea. Our thoughts circulated endlessly within the primordial sea. And we were no longer individuals. But we became one, Just as streams of water come together in the sea. I'm Cressy. I'm Lemony. I'm Azeen. The only one I am not is Vignier.
Why? But then...
She doesn't want to see you anymore. Every tendril of her consciousness is of... This is what you get for your selfishness. Your selfishness robbed us of our lives and our futures. You said time and time again that you'd do any and everything for her. But did you ever consider whether she'd want to see you do the things that you did? If she would despise you for what you became?
I
what? What do you gotta say for yourself?
You are a liar. A heartless murderer.
Tell it.
Cowardly narcissist.
Tell it.
The only thing you are not is Vignier's beloved. From the moment your first victim died and her consciousness merged with Vignier's, she has had nothing but pure hatred for you.
No! Vignier! She can't hate me. Let me see her.
You still don't understand. When I said don't look for me, that came from the real Vignier. But on top of that, she also said that because it's her final drop of pity for you. She said that because she knew that if you did come here, we will show no mercy to you.
Vache.
Vache?
Vache.
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 Vache. Drown.
Later in the garden, report for physicians that he died. He died from massive fright. Okay, damn. It's raining.
Finally, we have some time to do shopping. Gosh, it's really been a long time since we've been able to relax.
My legs are killing me.
Oh, well met, partner. I knew something great was going to happen when I woke up in such a good mood today.
Even this weather can't put a damper on the demoiselle's mood.
It's a pleasure to see you both again.
Love you, Silver. I'm your biggest fan.
Oh, hey, Navia. It's been a few days. Paimon's already started to miss you.
Oh, now that I believe. I'm easy to work with and always bring home the bacon. Who wouldn't treasure having a partner like me?
Sounds like you're really enjoying life these days, Navia. What have you been busy with since the trial?
It's just been one thing after the other. I've been making non-stop trips between Poisson and the court since then. Everyone from Spina di Rosula organized a memorial for my father. We never held a memorial when he first died, since everyone knew that even if we held one back then, no one was going to come. This time, though, everyone in Poisson, and even many people from the court, all attended.
So his name's definitely been cleared now. That's what we like to hear.
It's been the dearest wish of Demoiselle all along.
That blasted stubborn fool. I was right to put my faith in him. I'm so glad I didn't give up on the case all those years ago.
Things turned out just as they could have.
Oh, by the way... I ran into Charlotte just after I left the memorial service. Well, maybe it'd be more accurate to say I knew she would be there, and there was no way she'd just let me go.
Huh? So you know Charlotte too? The Charlotte? Journalist from the Steambird?
Yeah, way back when I first became the president of the Spina di Rosula, she was all over me. Wouldn't take no for an answer. I believe the story was called The True Heart of Darkness, Secret Tales of the Yellow Rose. To be fair, though, it was a really flattering feature. So, we've been on pretty good terms ever since. She was trying to lean on our friendship to get me to do an exclusive piece on the serial disappearances case.
Oh yeah, she told us about that. She's always been super interested in that case, so now her wish has finally come true too!
Anyway, I told her to make sure that when she writes about you guys entering the Opera House with the critical evidence, that you both sound really cool.
Now that's another thing to look forward to! We trust Charlotte's skills with a pen for sure!
Another region, another saving!
And in other news, I also took Clarand out for a meal.
Oh, are you two on better terms now?
While you were investigating Vache's headquarters, Clarand gave testimony on my father's behalf. It was thanks to her that we were able to turn the tide. I wanted to thank her. I mean, there's also no point in being awkward all the time. So we took the chance to reconcile with each other.
Aw, that's so good.
Oh, great. Paimon also thought Clarand wasn't actually a bad person. It's always good to have more friends.
Clarand is like the Cujo Sara of Fontaine.
Perhaps it will slowly begin to fade from the public consciousness. Oh, actually, there's still one last thing I need to do.
What is it?
I should pay a visit to my father's grave and tell him the truth of what happened, as well as how it all ended. And on top of that, just how much people still look up to him to this day. That includes me, too.
Miss Navia.
Indeed.
What about Child? Like, he's still in jail.
We also think Callus is a really admirable person.
Sure thing. I'd like you two to share the moment with me. After all, without you, there might not have been such a positive ending.
And in that case, everyone, let's be off.
Let's be off.
Woo-hoo. Considering the recent weather, we'll be lucky if we can reach Poisson before dark.
Poisson. Yeah,
you're right. It's been raining nonstop for a few days now.
And a chance of mourning.
This is where my father's grave is. To be perfectly honest, even I haven't been back here for a long time.
Huh? There's someone there already. Wait, that figure. It can't be.
Hmm?
Isn't that Nervalette? Why would the Chief Justice be here? Huh?
Navia? Navia?
My apologies. I should have asked before coming to pay my respects.
Don't say that.
Sorry about that.
Oh, I was trying to say there's no need for you to apologize. I wanted to show my father how much I've grown. But still, I doubt I've grown to the point that even the Chief Justice would feel compelled to apologize to me over and over.
In that case, I will stop apologizing for now.
You really could use some pointers on understanding human emotions, Monsieur Nervalette. In any case, why did you come to Poisson?
Well, ever since that day, I've been turning a question over and over in my head. Just what is justice, anyway? There was once a time when I didn't want to believe that there could be anything more important to humans than life itself. Oh, rather than that, it's probably more truthful to say I didn't believe humans were capable of resisting the most basic instinct of living things. That they could rebel against their own nature, or consider certain things to be more important than their own lives. Which is also why I didn't stop your father from beginning that fateful duel. I believed that a truly innocent man would never throw away his life like that. That there was nothing, should have been nothing more important than one's own continued survival. But Mr. Callus proved me utterly and decisively wrong. If not for his sacrifice, the serial disappearances case would have remained unsolved to this day. Mr. Callus made the choice he did for his daughter, for his associates, and for many people completely unrelated to him.
Listen, Nervalette is my favorite character in the Fontaine story. I'm sorry, I know it's probably still a little early to say that, but he is definitely my favorite right now. What a noble man.
And in the end, from a certain perspective, one could say that he did it all for the sake of justice. A justice that's higher than life itself. So, you asked me why I came here. I just wanted to say my apologies to Mr. Callis in person. I should have noticed all of this much sooner. This regret has filled me with a sadness that has haunted me for days. That high and mighty chair in the opera Epicles indeed insulates one from many important things. Spina di Rosula, thank you so much for your hard work and perseverance.
I'm sorry for being mad at you before.
So, you're actually one of those types that's cold on the outside, but pretty thoughtful on the inside, huh?
We love Silver!
That reminds me of Silver. One of my guys.
Sorry about that. Self-expression is not one of my strong suits.
Didn't I just say you don't need to apologize?
Sorry. 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 My apologies.
For now, we can wait till after they're done.
No.
Paimon's never paid respects at someone's grave before. Did Paimon do anything rude there?
Well, you're not usually supposed to fly around someone's grave.
Paimon didn't know that was a thing. But Paimon doesn't know what she would do if she can't fly.
Just sit on the ground.
No. Paimon hopes Miss Navia won't be too mad.
She took it seriously.
Anyway, Nervalette is still standing around there. It's not often that we can catch him alone like this, so why don't we go talk to him for a bit? If we can't talk to Lady Farina, we can at least talk to him, right?
Mm-hmm. He seems so peaceful. Hey. I'm walking. This is such a pretty scene. Hold on. I gotta get a picture of this. I have to take a screenshot for the memories. Hello, sir.
Oh, it's you two. Did Miss Navia invite you to come pay your respects to her father?
Mm-hmm. We ran into Navia on the streets today, so we just followed her here.
I see. Then is there something that I can help you with?
Possibly.
Like this, since you're usually super busy, so we figured we could try to ask you a few questions, if that's okay.
Please feel free. Though outsiders, you helped us solve one of the greatest mysteries in Fontaine, and it would be my pleasure to return the favor.
Oh. About Child.
My apologies. My investigation has still not reached its conclusion.
Oh, never mind then.
However, I still believe the judgment of the Oratrice was not rendered arbitrarily.
But you also said you thought he was innocent.
For many years, I have been quite aware that the Oratrice does not simply mechanically repeat the verdict that I give on each case. As a divinely created mechanism, the people's unified faith in the concept of justice is integrated into it. Not only can it produce the incredible power of indemnitium, but it likely also possesses other traits, such as self-awareness. Which is all to say, I've been prepared for a situation like this for a long time.
Huh. So when Linny told us that he heard a human voice from the room where the Oratrice's core is stored...
I was not aware such a thing had occurred. Perhaps that could serve to prove my conjecture. I will add that to the list of items to investigate. In any case, I am inclined to believe that the Oratrice does have a methodology all its own. We just do not have enough information. Based on Farina's reaction, I doubt even she had any idea what was going on. She managed to bluff her way through it, though, with her time-tested twin tricks of bravado and drama. While we do intend to get to the bottom of this, for now, we regret to say that the Fatui Harbinger will just have to bide his time in the Fortress of Meripede. If we did incorrectly convict him of crimes he did not commit, we will most certainly compensate him to the fullest extent allowed by the law.
If you ask Paimon, the only compensation he'll want is a no-holds-barred fight with you.
Is there anything else you'd like to ask me about?
That's very true. He'll probably want to fight you. What about the water?
So, at court, the bad guys referred to that special water as water from the primordial sea, but what is it really?
Truthfully, that name is already quite accurate. I can only surmise that Vache and his ilk only learned of its nature and existence after extensive research. There used to be a special sea on the surface of this planet. The nature of its seawater was rather different from that of the sea we know today. Most of Teyvat's life forms were first born in that special sea. You could say it nurtured much of the life on this planet.
Huh. So it really was where everything began. It makes sense to call it primordial, then.
But today, the primordial sea no longer exists on the planet's surface. What Vache discovered must have been some kind of special case, or a remnant from a truly ancient age.
Huh. So that's how it is. Oh, you really know everything, Monsieur Nervalette. But if that's the case, then why would people, at least people from Fontaine, dissolve in that kind of water?
Indeed. Why would the primordial sea, which was known to engender and nurture life, suddenly reverse itself and devour life instead? To be frank, that also doesn't match my understanding of this world and its laws. There must still be some unknown secrets around the people of this land. Is there anything else you'd like to ask me about?
He's so pretty. I love him. Prophecy.
That the sea levels will rise and everyone will be dissolved in water, leaving Farina crying alone on her throne, but the sins of the people will be finally washed away for good. Does that appropriately summarize the version you've heard?
Yes.
That's right! It was Linny that told us back then. And that about covers all the main points.
Yes, up to the present, I think we reached a point where we have no choice but to confront this prophecy directly. Rumors have it that this prophecy is rooted in the last words the former Hydro Archon left to the world before she passed away.
A prophecy? Of the former Hydro Archon? Wow. This is the first time that we've ever heard of it.
Two parts of the prophecy have already proven correct. The rising sea levels and the ability of the people of Fontaine to be dissolved. We should be more vigilant and stay on the watch for further signs. Speaking of the prophecy, Farina has also always taken it quite seriously. Indeed, she has been collecting information and intelligence from across Teyvat for this purpose. If the rumors were true, then perhaps this prophecy is the conundrum left to Farina by her predecessor.
But with Farina being the way she is, can we really trust her to solve it?
Is there anything else you'd like to ask me about?
Not the diversion. About my sibling.
Your sibling? Another blonde-haired traveler? I'm sorry, but I've never seen anyone who matches that description. If he ever stepped foot in Fontaine, I'm sure he followed our laws to the letter and had no reason to appear on the stage of the opera Epicles. Is there anything else you'd like to ask me about?
I have no more questions.
Very well. It was my honor to provide you with what answers I could. I very much enjoyed conversing with you.
Mm-hmm.
It will soon be time for me to leave this blissful tranquility behind and return to Palais Memoria.
Okay, I have a very kind of just inference. I feel like Nuvalette would interact with Ayato very, very well.
You really are super busy, Monsieur Nuvalette. Paimon thought you only came here to pay your respects today because you had the day off.
Crime and villainy do not have the day off, and so justice must work around the clock as well. This is merely the nature of a justice's work.
All right, you've got a point. Huh? Paimon just noticed that the rain has stopped.
No, Act 2 is finished. That's so upsetting. Anyway, I gotta get this teleport waypoint before I forget. And I believe that means I can start. Oh. Yeah. That means I can start exploring and stuff. That'll be fun. Probably do most of that stuff off stream, if I can. I'll be getting all the waypoints off stream for sure. Let me just get Catherine here in Fontaine, so that way if I do happen to stream tomorrow, I can start my commissions here in Fontaine. That'll be fun. Also, the more and more that I play this game, the more and more that I realize that this scenery looks similar to Fortnite's. That's... oh boy. So yeah, I might be back tomorrow, who knows. Anyway. I think that's gonna be it for today. I'm gonna have to go ahead and say goodbye, as I have no reason else to be doing that, and today's live stream is mostly meant for that. Again, if you haven't already, go ahead and join my Discord to know when I am live, or if you just want to interact and have fun. On top of that, you could also follow my Twitter, which I have been trying to keep up with, letting you guys know when I go live, so you can get an instant notification there on Twitter. Obviously, if you want, if you have any other things that you would like to say, you can just tell me, tell it straight to me on Twitter. I will respond immediately. That being said, I think that's going to be it for today's stream. I'm honestly super happy, and I don't think I'm going to be doing Linny's story quest on stream, but if I might end up doing that, but it probably is going to be a few days from now. So yeah, I will see you guys next time.